In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create this vertical format slideshow. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. We'll use different motion design techniques to make the slideshow truly unique. That'll give you all the tools to expand it and add more content. Alright, let's jump right in. I've already created three comps, 1080 by 1920 pixels, named pick 1, 2, and 3, and added pictures, which I downloaded from Unsplash. Links in the description. Next, let's create another comp, 1080 by 1920 pixels as well, 192 frames long. We name it slideshow. Then, let's start with the background. We add a new solid, Command or Control Y, name it background, color doesn't matter. Then we use the effects and presets window and search for the gradient ramp. Add it and adjust the colors. Going from a dark blue at the top to black towards the bottom. Then we add mosaic. Set horizontal blocks to 1, vertical blocks to 8. And check sharp colors, which creates these color blocks. Then we add CC line sweep. Completion 100. Direction 0. Thickness 60. Slant 0. Then we go to the beginning and set a completion keyframe. After 10 frames, we set completion to 0, which reveals the background layer. We duplicate the layer, move the beginning to 48 frames, and change the colors. Let's go for some magenta and cyan at the bottom. We press U to see this layer's keyframes. And let's move the second completion keyframe to 148 frames. Awesome! On top of that, let's add a grid. With no layer selected, we grab the pen tool from the toolbar and draw a horizontal line across the screen. Let's name it grid. Then we open the contents property and add a repeater. Set copies to around 50 and open the transform property and set the position to 0 and 60. Then we position it. Switch back to the selection tool so that the lines align with the edges of the color blocks. We use the pen tool again and add a vertical line. We add the repeater to the first shape, then we open the new shape property and add a repeater as well. Around 50 copies, position, this time 60 and 0. Then we add Gaussian blur and set the blurriness to 5. Awesome, that's our grid. I figure out the numbers before so that the color blocks, the grid, and the transition of the background match. Then, let's add our three pictures. Pick one at 10 frames, endpoint 66 frames. Scale 80%. Pick two below, starting at 60 frames. Until 112 frames. Scale 80% as well. Pick 3 from 110 frames until the end. Scale around 87%. Let's add the first pick for now and add a solid below it. Rename it checkerboard. Move the start point to 7 frames, the end to 60. We scale it down to 85%. Let's actually change the color to white. Then we add checkerboard. We set the blending mode to normal. Let's double the width to 32. And change the color into a light gray. Looks like a transparent area. We make the pick 1 comp visible again and move it out of the screen. We go to 10 frames, open the position property and set a position keyframe. At 20 frames, it is back in the screen, slightly above and left of the checkerboard. We set another position keyframe at 34 frames and a scale keyframe. At 36 frames, we move it to the center, roughly, and scale it up to 90%. We set another position keyframe at 60 frames. At 65 frames, we move it out of the screen again. Then we select all keyframes and add Easy Ease in. We open the scale property of the third picture, scale it down to 15% at the beginning, set a keyframe. After 2 frames, we scale it back up to 87%. We set another keyframe at 160 frames. 2 more frames later, we scale it up to around 120%. By the way, if you like this video so far, please leave a like. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks very much, guys. Did you see that the background transition doesn't go all to the end? Let's check that out. First keyframe 100. Here we go. That should be 0, of course. Next, we grab the title tool and add some text. Caption this in my case. Size around 65. No fill. White outline, 3 pixels. Depending on the font you use, of course. We select the text, copy it and paste it at the end. A few times. Then we move it down, below the pick 2 comp. And adjust the start and end point. And with the layer selected, we add a rectangular mask. Open path options and set path to mask 1. Force alignment on. Then we adjust the size of the mask until the text is like a frame around the picture. Oh, so one more time. All right. We set keyframes for the first and last margin at the beginning and set them both to, let's say, 135 at the end. Awesome. With no layer selected, we double click on the rounded rectangle tool. Move the new shape below the text layer, adjust the start and end point, fill a bright blue. Let's adjust the size so that it's like the background of the text. Wait a minute, and no stroke. Let's see. All right. We're making progress. We grab the title tool again and add some text, all capitals. Much bigger this time, around 300 pixels. Let's make that line longer. All right. Let's move the start point to 116 frames and position the text somewhere towards the top. Then we animate the position with 2 keyframes. One at the beginning, move the text to the left at the end. We duplicate the layer, move it below the picture. Change the outline color to blue. Then we add CC Rapid Tile. And expand it up and down. Until the whole screen is covered. Tiling, break. Next, let's add some text boxes or lower thirds. We grab the title tool, add text. This time 2 lines. Fill color, black. Size, 65 pixels, leading around 140. Seems a bit small. So let's change it to 150. We position it somewhere in the bottom right corner. Then we grab the rectangle tool and add a box. Move it below the text. Let's name it lower third. We need to move it further down, of course, to see the text. No stroke, fill a bright yellow. Let's move the text layer down as well. And position the 2 shapes. Here maybe. The 2 layers start at 15 frames, end at 60 frames. And to reveal the shape, we add CC line sweep again. Completion 100, direction 0, thickness 146, slant 50. Then we animate the completion, 100 at the beginning, 0 at 24 frames. Let's press U to see the keyframes in the timeline. 0 at 55 frames. Wait a minute, let's check that. 0 here and 0 here. Then 100 again at 59 frames. Then we add the set matte effect to the text layer. Take the matte from the shape below, effects and masks. Awesome. We duplicate the two layers, move them to 66 frames. Position them somewhere below the middle. And update the matte layer and the set matte effect. We duplicate them one more time, move them to 116 frames and position them at the top. And update the matte layer. Awesome. Let's add some more details. We move to the beginning. With no layer selected, we grab the star tool. Double click on it. Points, 4. Inner radius, 0. Outer radius, 506. Rotation, 45 degrees. Stroke width, 4. Let's be good and name it, right? Length, only 2 frames. Then let's duplicate it. Move it to 64 frames, to 112 frames, and to 140 at the top. I've added a red frame around the first picture and some more small crosses along the way. The more details, the better. Now it's your turn to go on from there, extend it, add more pictures. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks so much for watching this video. See you in the next video. Bye, guys.